At each other, sometimes at things, sometimes you're taking it out on each other or whatever, but you need to stay. My recommendation is to stay up as late as you have to stay up to resolve. It's okay if you have disagreements. It's okay if you have those bad days, but you need to make sure that you and Justin and that you and Michelle are encouraging. And this is forever. This message isn't just for y'all, this is for every husband, wife, or someone out there that wants to be married, is I would encourage you to take time to read God's Word today. And hopefully you can do that later. But for sure, plan some time to have Bible study together. And then another very important thing is we all get very busy with our lives, is one day a week, plan a date night where it's just you and her. Not you and her and Facebook, not you and her in a game, not you and her and the guys. I mean, you know, it needs to be just you two. You need to set that time aside because she is your wife and he is your husband. I think you will be on a great path to a happy and healthy and strong marriage. And I want to encourage y'all to do that. Now, at this time, we're going to share the vows. If you would please turn and face one another. Now, these vows They're as binding as in adversity as they are in prosperity, and they should only be broken by death. And if you're prepared to do that, I'll ask you first, Justin. Justin, in taking Michelle to be your wife, do you so promise to love her in sickness and in health, in poverty as in wealth, in hardship as in blessing, until death alone separates you? Michelle, in taking Justin to be your husband, do you promise to respect him in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, in hardship as in blessing, until death alone separates you? Now, the commitment that you two have made to one another here today. And also we use range because there's no beginning and there's no end. If you would please, Justin, would you take Michelle's ring, place it on her finger, and repeat after me. I, Justin.
Take you, Michelle.
I would appreciate that. Okay. Thank you, Michelle.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
I pledge before God and these witnesses. Place your good above mine.
Now and always.
No matter the circumstances. I promise to love you.
And cherish you.
Until death do us part. Joyfully and willingly. I commit myself to you.
And to you alone.
Michelle, take you, Justin. To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward, I pledge before God and these witnesses to place your good above mine. Now and always, no matter the circumstances, I promise to respect and to cherish you until death do us part. Joyfully and willingly, I commit myself to you and to you alone. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you so much for what you've done in our lives. Lord, I pray that you be with Justin and Michelle. And be with all of us here. And I pray that in our relationships, that we seek to honor you in everything that we do. And I pray for Justin and Michelle as Justin seeks to love her. And I pray that you be with Michelle as she seeks to respect him. Lord, that's so easy to do in the good times. It's so easy to do in the beginning. But Lord, I pray that they'll remember this day. They'll see their rings. They'll see the pictures. And just being with each other, they'll remember the commitment today, and I pray that they'll just honor you and all that they do. And you say that way. Amen. And privilege to declare you husband and wife, Justin, you may kiss your bride. Friends and family of the bride and groom, it's my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Gibbs. The first three rows of faces.